Precision 18 Forecast, News 18. There from where you live.
Well, a lot of rain in this forecast. That's really the focus here, is the ice and snow and bitter cold focus to flooding. But it will turn sharply colder again later on in the week, and a cold weather pattern will kind of get going and last through a good chunk of February. But the wind chill by Friday night of this week may drop to 10 below zero. So, no, it's not 40, 50 below, but it is going to be pretty bitterly cold come Friday and into Friday night, even Friday morning of this week. In the meantime, there's a cold front right here. It's got some drizzle and some showers with it. The most widespread rain's been just southeast of us today, so rainfall totals have been light, which is a good thing because we've got river flooding and creek flooding underway. But the elements coming together, there's an Arctic front here, bitterly cold air right over this region. This is dropping southward. There's a big storm here that'll roll this way, and there's very deep tropical moisture originating near Hawaii moving northward. This means heavy rain here, an all-out ice storm here in the plains just northwest of our area, and a front that will be just north of us, so we'll be on the mild side of it. You can see the creek, stream, and river flood warnings and advisories up for the area, and with a 1 to 2 inch rainfall ahead, these levels rising. Notice the rainfall from now right to late Thursday and Friday, good solid 1 to 2 inches. There may be a couple locations that exceed 2 inches of rainfall on ground that can't absorb anymore. The back edge of this rain and drizzle this evening may end briefly as a couple patches of freezing drizzle. Doesn't look like a big deal though. Then we see some clearing tonight as we drop into the 20s, wind chills around 10 in the morning. And then the clouds roll back in later tomorrow, and tomorrow night, the north may see a burst of freezing rain. And check this out, I can't even rule out a few isolated rumbles of thunder or flashes of lightning either. With showers around, this is 3 o'clock tomorrow morning, a lot of rain, couple thunderstorms around early Wednesday morning, and the rain may subside briefly for a while Wednesday early afternoon before it ramps back up again in the late afternoon, evening, and into the night. And then Thursday, same song and dance. Heavy rain coming in may end briefly, you can see right here, as a little bit of icy mix. That would be later Thursday evening. So this evening, showers and drizzle taper to a few patches of drizzle and freezing drizzle, 32 by 11. Tomorrow, sun early, but then we cloud up with a high of 38 after 20s in the morning and the wind decreasing. And finally, by Wednesday, rain tapers in the morning and even a little thunder and lightning in places with fog. And then the rain returns later on in the day with a high of 51 with areas of dense fog. With this kind of weather that is very active, you want to stay on the WLFI app and Chad's blog. I've got a new blog entry up right now that talks about this changing weather and just how it's going to last really over the next few weeks. 19 on Friday, that's it, Jordan. 9 Friday morning, and then we may see some minor accumulating snow on Sunday. Hard to fit all that into 3 minutes.
Yeah, a lot of different stuff. Thank you, Chad. Okay.